My name is Zhao Li. Today, we'll talk about how we can incorporate rules into agent prediction models in autonomous driving.
Recent advances in trajectory prediction takes advantage of important priors about the problem domain, such as multimodality of possible futures, interactions among road agents, and dynamics.
Rules are another type of expressive priors that are more commonly adopted as objectives or constraints in planners of the Eagle vehicle. Here, I'm showing two rules from the Mobileye RSS. For simple rules such as the ones presented here, one can design functions that accurately express them with relatively less effort. However, when the number of rules becomes large and the complexity of each rule increases, it can be a challenge to provide a formalism that conveniently expresses the rules and have them interact in a coherent manner. Incorporating rules into prediction models is also a research problem. Rules widely exist in the driving domain, ranging from rules of the road, state regulations, and heuristics of best driving practices. These rules can be as simple as stop at the red light or as complex as instructions for a flagger sign. The goal of this work is to leverage formal language as an expressive means to encode rules and to develop a method that integrates the rules into prediction models. Here, I will briefly introduce our formal language of choice, signal temporal logic, or STL for short. STL consists of a set of predicates which are inequalities of real value functions, a set of Boolean operators, as well as temporal operators. With STL, we can express requirements on temporal sequences such as eventually from 0 to 2 time steps, as one has to be smaller than 3, and always from 5 to 7 time steps, as one has to stay within the range of 0 to 5. STL is equipped with a set of quantitative semantics, also referred to as robustness degrees, which is a function that takes its input, an STL formula, and a state sequence, and outputs a number called robustness value, or robustness for short. The state sequence satisfies the STL formula if the robustness is greater than 0, and violates otherwise. The robustness serves as a continuous measure of satisfaction, which we will use to create rule-abiding predictions. This diagram shows our general architecture. We start with an off-the-shelf Bayes predictor. The Bayes predictor takes in its required input features and produces a trajectory for the agent's future, illustrated by the white dots. The STL layer takes in the Bayes prediction alongside the STL rules and additional information necessary to evaluate the robustness, and performs a number of optimization rollout steps. The output of the STL layer is a corrected trajectory illustrated by the red dots that is compliant with the Gamer rules. Expanding the STL layer shows that in the forward pass, we take k gradient descent steps with the robustness as the objective function and the trajectory as the parameter to be optimized. This gives us an updated trajectory with higher robustness values and hence more rule compliant. In practice, instead of optimizing directly for the robustness, we can optimize for a set of controls and use a dynamics model to calculate the trajectory. This can give us more dynamically feasible predictions. Recall that the basic elements of the rules are predicates, which are inequalities of real value functions. We set the thresholds of the predicates as rule parameters. These parameters can be optimized in a backward pass. For example, the rule stay close to the center lane can be expressed as the distance between the agent to the center lane bounded by a threshold. Setting this threshold too high reduces the influence of the rule on prediction, where setting it too low puts too much restriction on prediction and reduces flexibility. Manual tuning of these parameters can be tedious. Our method allows for automatic optimization of these rule parameters as part of the backward pass.
We evaluate our approach on the NewSense dataset and use three rules for testing. The first rule states that an agent should always stay close to the center lane. The second rule states that the corrected prediction should stay close to the Bayes prediction. And the third rule indicates that if there is no stop areas within 30 meters ahead of the agent, then drive close to the current speed.
We adopt the multimodal trajectory predictor, or MTP, as our Bayes predictor. The histogram shows that incorporating the rules reduces the average displacement error, especially in the long tail regions. However, we also witnessed the occurrence of overcorrection in the low error regions, where the actual behavior of the agents are not compliant with the rules that we provided. Overall, we see a 5 to 6% reduction in average error and 10 to 30% reduction in maximum error in the given validation set. We also evaluate in terms of prediction horizon and sample efficiency. We set the prediction horizon from 9 seconds to 12 seconds in 3-second intervals. Sample efficiency is evaluated by training with 30, 50, and 70% of the training data. In both cases, integrating rules results in performance improvements, especially in the long prediction horizon and low data cases. Here, the result for automatic rule parameter tuning is provided for the rule always stay close to the center lane. The scene on the left shows an overcorrection scenario, where the corrected trajectory shown in red conforms with the rule but deviates further from the ground truth trajectory shown in black. This happens in cases where the agent is not driving according to the rules. As shown by the middle plot, the rule parameter, which is the distance threshold, is relaxed as training progresses to allow for more flexible behavior. This results in a better correction shown in the scene on the right.
In conclusion, we introduce a differentiable logic layer that integrates STL rules into existing trajectory prediction models to provide useful priors. The logic layer supports automatic tuning of rule parameters to adapt to data. Evaluation on a driving dataset shows increased accuracy as well as effective reduction of long-tail error. If you have further questions, please feel free to contact me at xiaoli@mit.edu. Thank you.